Welcome to the game. All right, the reliquary box. So, as I started to read through the rule book for Joan of Arc, it says the scenarios use the contents from the core box and the reliquary box. So I thought it might be important that we take a look and see what's inside of this. And this box is the same size. Not quite as heavy, not nearly as heavy as the main box, but oh, come on. This box is huge. And since you saw earlier, it's got its own, everything's got its own shelf. All right, so what's in here? Reliquary box in French as well as English. So it's gonna add more scenarios. Child, no more room in hell. Vlad, we'll get to fight Dracula in here. All right, again, we have more cards. All the troops added in this box. All right, the cards are coming both French and English, so you really only need one set of those. But... is just cool. That's very cool. A whole some of the larger monsters. The Kickstarter, it unlocked a ton of stuff. But it's times like these when you start to think, what did I get myself into? Oh, there's a ton of models in the box. Alright, let's go. Spacer. All right, now this should be the beast. Wow. Look at that. Seven heads, clawed feet. That is a massive model. That's super cool. All right, that is the reliquary box. Now we have everything to play all the scenarios in the main rulebook. Now, I have spent the last 20 plus minutes punching all of those cardboard pieces from the main book, or from the main box. There's a lot of stuff, and all that came out of the core box. This is a 4x4 tables. There's a lot of stuff for this game. And we still have three more expansions to go to unbox the Wave 1 shipment of Time of Legends, Joan of Arc. So, with that, I am going to find a space, set up the first scenario, and learn how to play this game. So, back with more as soon as we can. Thanks for watching.